Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome back. I hope you guys are having a great summer. As you guys know, training camp is right around the corner. We're done with free agency, the NBA draft, summer league. LeBron is still playing basketball, though. If you guys saw him, he was at Seattle at the Jamal Crawford Pro-Am. I mean, he played in the Drew League, now the Seattle Pro-Am, and with Jamal Crawford and them. I mean, he's been playing a lot of basketball this summer, but I think that's a testament to the body. He's keeping himself in shape and things of that nature. But as far as today, I'm here to talk about Kendrick Nunn. Obviously the mystery, right? He hasn't played in a Laker uniform yet, right? We thought he was going to play at some point last year. Obviously it didn't work out that way. But luckily he did say that he feels 100%, but he is not playing in 5-on-5 at this moment. But I don't think that's nothing really to worry about at this point. I think the fact that he says at 100% tells me that he will be ready by training camp. And I'm here to talk about what could he bring to this Lakers team, especially offensively. I mean, obviously, there's still a big cloud over Russell Westbrook. Will he be on the roster or not? So I'm just going to assume everything is as constructed at this moment, because I think Kendrick Nunn will obviously be the backup point guard. He's a guy that can come off the bench and not only create for himself, he can create for others as well. If you look at his assist numbers, they may not be too high, but you have to consider the team that he was on and the way that it was structured, right? I think with the Lakers, obviously the shooting is still a question mark, but he's a guy that if you can mix in there with either LeBron or AD, because they're going to stagger their minutes. I don't think you'll see a lot of times where they're both not on the floor at the same time. He's another ball handler. If he's in there with AD, he's a guy that can be used in the pick and roll. And he's a really underrated shooter. And I was looking at this, and you know, you may be surprised that he could possibly get in this category, because very few guys reach this level. I'm talking about a particular club, and that's the 50-40-90 club. If you're not familiar, shoot at least 50% from the field, 40% from three, and 90% from the charity stripe. In his last season with the Miami Heat, he was close to those numbers. He really was. He shot 48% from the field, 38% from three, and 93% from the free throw line. And that was on higher usage, obviously. His usage that year was 20.9. And the year before that, it was 24.1. Obviously, on the same team as LeBron, your usage is going to go down a lot. Now, like I said, he may not be on the floor with LeBron that much, so that usage number could be skewed a little bit, but still at the same time, I imagine his usage would not be as high as it was during his Miami years, which could lead to higher efficiency. Obviously, the less you shoot, the higher percentage should be in theory, right? So I think, I know a lot of Laker fans are still worried, and it's a big mystery, obviously, because he didn't play last year, but there are a lot of qualities to like the Kendrick Nunn's game. He's a really good ball handler, like I mentioned, very underrated shooter. And I really, really believe that if you can get him in those pick and roll situations, you can draw the defense in. He's the guy that can make those first read and second reads. Right now, the guy's got to knock down the shots, obviously. And that's going to be up to guys like a THT, a Stanley Johnson, a Austin Reeves, right? Guys like that to make those corner threes. But I do believe last year we saw that the Lakers were lacking that extra ball handler that could kind of slow down the tempo, play at a good pace, and at times even push the tempo, right? Because we know that the Lakers actually are really, really good when they push the tempo. They just didn't do it as often. But I think with a new scheme, a new system, new philosophy with Darvin Ham and what he preaches, I think you will see this team push the tempo a lot more. Because when they do that, that's when they're at their best. Because in the half court, obviously, things can get boggled up. Teams can set their defense. And outside of LeBron, you don't really have that many creators for themselves, right? LeBron has to create everything. So with Kendrick Nunn there, I think that will help the half court some, but you still want to run. But don't be surprised, I'm the first one to say it, if Kendrick Nunn could make the 50-40-90 club. I'm not predicting it. I'm just putting it out there. He was close to his last full season. I know he missed some games still in Miami, but he's a guy that's capable of doing it. He really, really is. And it all depends on the usage. So thank you guys for tuning in to this special edition on Lakers Nation. Talk to you guys soon.